Hello guys, maybe you have already seen images like this, showing the movement of gases produced by a flame or something similar. This process is called Schlieren photography. To be able to capture those images, you usually need complex setups with parabolic mirrors or lenses, and your field of view is limited by the diameter of the lens or mirror. What if you want to use it with something bigger, like an airplane? Good luck finding an airplane-sized mirror. There are other ways to obtain a Schlieren image. For example, analyzing the background disturbance of an image. This process is called synthetic Schlieren. In this example, from NASA, they use the texture of the soil and the vegetation as a background. While there is an airplane recording from above, two lower ones pass by. And after some image processing, we have this result. The background can be anything that has a texture. In this video, I will use a checkered pattern projected on a monitor, and to record, I will use my cell phone. Here's the checkered pattern that I used, in case you want to try for yourself. And this is the video that I made. You can barely see the disturbances. We need to process this image. And how we are going to do that? With Python and the OpenCV library. CV here stands for computer vision. After importing OpenCV, we have to open the video file and save the first frame as a reference. Within the loop, we will go through all the frames of the video and subtract the reference frame from each one of them. Then we will show the result on the screen. When the S key is pressed, the loop is interrupted. After finishing, we close the video file and the display window. And this is the result. Now we can see a little more of the gases coming out of the candle. But the contrast is still very, very bad. To improve the contrast, first I will throw away the pixels with a lower value. This is important to remove some of the noise. Then I will also remove the higher value pixels, so that I can multiply the values by 4 without maxing out the 255 limit. And now we have this result here. You can see much better the gases coming out of the candle, but there's still a lot of noise in the image. We can apply some type of noise filter. OpenCV has several that are ready to use. Another option is to make a type of temporal filter. In the temporal filter, we will calculate a mean frame from the outputs, and then subtract it from the output itself. This removes some of those lines that appear on the background. And here we have the comparison with the four different filters. At the end, I think the best result is the temporal filtering. But there are many other filters that I didn't get to test. The way that we are doing the processing here, subtracting the background from each frame, we need to have the camera fixed on one point of view, or else we will need to reposition the background for each frame. That can be very cumbersome. In this case, we have another option, subtract consecutive frames from each other. You only need to update the reference every time you go through the loop. The result is generally not as good as the previous one. It doesn't work very well for laminar flows, where there's not much difference between the frames. You can see here the comparison, without any filtering. And now we can export the processed video. First, we need to know the dimensions of the frame. Then prepare the output file and save each frame inside the loop, and at the end, close the file. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, until the next time. Thank you.